I, Professor Vishal Taylor, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you the centrifugal pump construction and working of centrifugal pump with complete animations. And I give you sorry, after watching this video, you are never need to watch the construction and working of centrifugal pumps. So I request to watch the video up to the end. So first, we move towards the constructions of a centrifugal pump. Now, the pump is generally used to transfer a liquid from a lower head to higher head. So the water store in the lower head, it is known as the sump level. Okay. So suppose this is the water store on this area and we are required to supplying the water at these higher heads. Okay. So here we understand its construction. So in this construction, at the lowermost component, it is known as the foot wall and strainers. And it is connected on the one end of the suction pipe. So it is the suction pipe. So what is suction pipe, foot wall and strainers, that we learn. Then we move towards the next component. So suction pipe, it carry the liquid from the sump to the pump. Means this is the sump and here the pump is installed. So it carry the liquid from sump to pump. It is lower end is dipped into the sump. Means one end, it is lower end, it's known, and this is known as the upper end. Lower end is submerged inside the sump level and it is connected at the foot wall and the strainers, and upper end is connected with the eye of the pump, that is the inlet of the pump, it is known as the eye of the pump. Strainer and foot wall are connected at the lower end, that already discussed. The strainer, what is the function of strainer? Strainer keeps the debris away from entering into the suction pipe, hence only clear water enters into the impellers. In the waters, there are lots of impurities and the waste particles are there. So they are not supplying by using this strainer. So only the clean water is supplied into the suction pipe. If any other debris is supplied in this impeller, then destroy the impellers and create the problems. Now next, what is the function of foot wall? The foot wall is a one kind of non-return wall. Means this part is known as the foot wall. It is a one way, means non-return means it is only open in a one direction, means it is only open in upper direction and water is supplied. Then after it is again closed, so water is not going back to the sump level. Okay. Then it is known as the non-return valve. Cavitations may be caused due to the negative pressures at the suction of the pump, hence losses at the inlet of the pump must be minimized. Okay. And to keep the low velocity in suction pipe, normal diameter in a suction pipe is kept more than to the delivery pipe. Means suction pipe diameter is larger compared to the delivery pipe. Why? To maintain the low velocity in a suction pipe. So these are these introductions of a suction pipe. Now we move towards the second components. So it is the shaft of this pump, and this portion is known as the eye of a pump, and this portion is known as the impellers. So now we study about this impeller, what is impeller and its function. It is a wheel or a rotor which is provided with series of backward curve end or a blades. Means this is the wheel. On this wheel, we are installed a number of vanes. See, its red color is number of vanes. The shape of the van is the backward curve end. It is mounted on a shaft which is coupled to an external source of energy. So this wheel of an impeller is mounted on this shaft. Okay, and this shaft is connected with the another external source. Another external source means from which we are supplying the mechanical power. It may be electric motor, it may be IC engine, or it may be another source which imparts electric motor is supplying energy to this impeller, and impeller is rotated. So it gets the mechanical energy and convert into the kinetic energy and pressure energy of the liquid. Means this impeller is rotated. Okay, so due to this impeller is rotated, it creates the centrifugal force. So what is the name of this pump? Pump name is centrifugal pump. Means pump is increased the pressure by using the centrifugal force. So when this pump is rotated, water comes from this part, I portion. It's going away due to the centrifugal force and it's increased the velocity. Okay, that's why it is known as the centrifugal pump. The liquid enters in the impeller through an eye of an impeller, means it is entered from here, and the high energy liquid then enters into the pump casing. So another part is the casing where it is entered from this impeller. Now this third part is the casing, Okay, the any system or a component have an outer body and it is known as the casing. So in a centrifugal pump there is a various type of casing is used. But if you want to learn the various type of casing, then I request you to watch my video on a classification of centrifugal pump. Okay, so here I writing the few points about this casing. It is an airtight passage surrounding the impellers. It is a completely airtight passage and it is surround the impeller. Designed in such a way that kinetic energy of the water discharge at the outlet of the impeller is converted into the pressure energy before the waters leave the casing and enter the delivery pipe. That means water coming out from this impeller which have a kinetic energy, means high kinetic energy. So from the pump is used to increase the pressure head. Okay, so water coming out with the high velocity from this impeller, it supply into this casing, and in this casing this kinetic energy of the water is converted into this pressure energy. So what is function of casing? To convert the kinetic energy of a water into the pressure energy. Material of this casing is generally cast iron and cast steel. The efficiency of the pump is depend on the type of the casing used. The following three types of casings are commonly used. First is the volute casing, second is vortex casing, and the third one is casing with guide blades. And the last component is the delivery pipe and delivery valve. Okay, so here this delivery valve. Now delivery pipe, a pipe was one end is connected to the outlet of the pump and another end delivers the waters at the required height. Means this is the outlet from this casing. So delivery pipe one end is connected with this casing of the pump and another end is connected at the which we are required to supply the water. The velocity of this liquid in a delivery pipe is kept slightly higher than that in the suction. Means velocity in this delivery pipe is higher than the velocity in this suction pipe. The valve is provided just near the pump outlet to regulate the flow of liquid in delivery pipe. Means this delivery valve is used to regulate the quantity of water supply from the pump. So here the construction is over, completed. Now we move towards the working. Before that I request to subscribe my channels by pressing subscribe buttons and also press the bell icon to get the continuous notification. Like the video, comment on the video and share with your friends. Now next is the working of a centrifugal pump. So first, before starting a centrifugal pump, a liquid is filled in suction pipe, impellers and casing and delivery pipe. And this is known as the priming. Means when we start the pump, priming is done. Means one opening is provided on the casing. From this opening, water is manually returned, or there is a various type of priming methods. For the priming methods, you can watch my video from going to the playlist and also from these descriptions. So water is added in this casing, in the suction pipes and the delivery pipe. Then here you saw that the casing is filled with the water, its color is changed. After priming, prime mover means prime mover, that is electric motor or IC engine or any other device, is start, and delivery valve is still kept closed. Means this delivery valve is kept closed. Energy given to the impeller by external source is transferred to the working fluid. Means what amount of the energy supplied from the prime mover to this impeller, and due to that impeller is start to rotate. Okay, and this rotation of impeller is caused strong suction at the eye of the pump. Means this impeller is create the strong suction. Okay, and this the vacuum is created and it help to liquid to rush out from a sump to that. Okay, so impeller is start to rotate, and due to the centrifugal force, means the air or water present here, it's going away from the center. So it is known as the centrifugal force, and the centrifugal force is create the vacuum on this eye. Okay, and due to this vacuum, the water in a sump level is start to rise in these upper directions. Okay, and the water from the suction pipe is start to come in these impellers, and these impellers is increase the velocity of the water, and this high velocity of the water is supplied into this casing. In this casing, the kinetic energy of the water is converted in the pressure energy. That's why it is known as the rotodynamic pump. Then after the high pressure or high pressure head of the water is supplied to this tank from this delivery pipe. So this is the working of a centrifugal pump. So this arrow is moving, that suction is takes place. Then after water is coming impellers. So water is circulated in this pipe, in this casing, and so it is rotated. After this impeller attains the normal speed, means after attaining normal speeds, the delivery valve is open, means this valve is open and the liquid is allowed to flow through these impeller vanes, and it's attained the higher velocity at the outlet periphery. And liquid enters in the casing due to special designs of the casing. Velocity of the liquid is increased and pressure energy hence increase. With high pressure energy and negligible kinetic energy, liquid enters into this delivery pipe and it's lifted in the required height. So here you see that color is changed and the water is delivered through in the tank through this delivery valve. So you can see that is a completely suction is takes place. After that water is going in this casing and from the casing it is going into this delivery pipe. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.